the Wild Things Are. Story and pictures by Maurice Sendak.
The night Max wore his wolf suit and made mischief of one kind and another.
His mother called them wild things. So Max said, "I'll eat you up." So he was sent to bed without eating anything. That very night in Max's room, the forest grew and grew and grew until the ceiling hung with flax and became the world all around.
And an ocean tumbled by
with a private boat for Max. And he sailed off through a night and a day, and in and out of a year, to where the wild things are. And when he came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars. And they gnashed their terrible teeth. And they rolled their terrible eyes. And they showed their terrible claws.
Max said, "Be still." And he tamed them with the magic trick of staring into all their yellow eyes without blinking once.
And they were frightened. And they called him the most wild thing of all and made him the king of all the wild things. And now, cried Max, let the wild rumpus start. Now stop, says Max.
And sent the wild things off to bed without their supper.
And Max, the king of all wild things, was lonely and wanted to be where someone loved him best of all. From all around and far away, he smelled around the world. He smelled good things to eat. So he gave up being king of where the wild things are. But the wild things cried, "Oh, please don't go. We'll eat you up. We love you so."
And Max said, "No." The wild things roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. But Max stepped into his private boat and waved goodbye.
He sailed back over a year and in and out of weeks and through a day. And into the night of his very own room where he found a supper waiting for him.
And it was still.